నా పేరు ఎస్ వెంకటప్ప. ఫారెస్ట్ రేంజ్ ఆఫీసర్ రిటైర్డ్. చిత్తూరు డిస్టిక్ వికోట నేటివ్. నేను ఈ నారాయణ హృదయాలయ హాస్పిటల్ అడ్మిట్ అయినప్పుడు శ్రీ హరీష్ డాక్టర్ గారు ఇన్ఛార్జి. కానీ నా పరిస్థితి చాలా నోటి మాట లేదు, శరీరం కదలడం లేదు. నాకు ఆస్మా, గుండె జబ్బు, కిడ్నీ రిపోర్టు, ఐసీయూలో 3 మంత్స్ పెట్టినారు. అప్పటి నుండి గ్రాడ్యువల్గా బాగా సార్ డాక్టర్ గారు, దేవుడు హరీష్ డాక్టర్ గారు నాకు బాగా చేసినారు. కనీసము ఒక స్టెప్ కూడా ముందు వేసేయలేదన్నమాట. కాళ్ళు చేయలు కదలడం లేదు. అలాంటిది ఇప్పుడు పరిగెత్తేటట్టు చేసినారు. నాకు ఆయన నాకు ఈ పునర్జన్మ ఇచ్చినారు ఈ హాస్పిటల్లో. నేను అందరికీ చెప్పుకున్నాను. లేకుంటే నేను ఇక్కడ బతకలేను. కాబట్టి నాకు ఎంతో స్ఫూర్తినిచ్చింది. నాకు ఇంతకుముందు కూడా గుండె జబ్బు కోసం వచ్చింటిని, కానీ ఆ డాక్టర్లు వేరు, ఈ డాక్టర్ వేరు. ఈయన ఎంతో సౌమ్యుడు, చాలా ఓపికగా వింటారు, కోపం చేసుకోరు, బాగా అన్నీ అడుగుతారు, వ్యాధి లక్షణాలు చెప్తారు, ట్యాబ్లెట్స్ గురించి చెప్తారు. మాకు ఏమి కావాలన్నా మా డౌట్లు క్లియర్ చేస్తారు. మాకు ఎలాంటి ఇబ్బంది లేదు ఈ డాక్టర్ వల్ల. అందువల్ల ఆ సారు మాకెంతో దేవునితో సమానం. మాకు ఇక్కడ పునర్జన్మ ఇచ్చినారు కాబట్టి వాళ్ళ బిడ్డలు పాపలకి భార్యకి ఎంతో శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర స్వామి ఆయురారోగ్యములతో ఇవ్వాలని భగవంతుని నేను కోరుకొనుచున్నాను. నాకు ఎంతో 100% నా వ్యాధులని నయం చేసినారు. ఇది నిజము.
హాయ్, మై నేమ్ ఇస్ డాక్టర్ హరీష్ మల్లాపురం మహేశ్వరప్ప. ఐఎమ్ ఇంటెన్సివ్ కేర్ ఫిజిషియన్ ఇన్ ముజుమ్దార్ షా మెడికల్ సెంటర్, నారాయణ హృదయాలయ, బెంగళూరు. సో నౌ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు షేర్ ఏ స్టోరీ ఆఫ్ ఏ పేషెంట్ వాజ్ 75-year మేల్ హూమ్ వీ లిటరలీ గివ్ ఏ సెకండ్ లైఫ్. సో ఈ వాజ్ ఏ నోన్ అస్థమాటిక్, గాట్ అడ్మిటెడ్ 6 మంత్స్ బ్యాక్ విత్ అ increase in his breathing difficulty. So then we find out the cause for his breathing difficulty was his infection, may not be just an asthma. So he was having a very bad urinary tract infection that we call it as urosepsis. So because of that infection which spread throughout the body, we call it as a septic shock. So he was already have a problem with multiple organs. His kidney got affected, his creatinine was more than 3, no urine production, severe acid was formed in his body. So we put him on the mechanical ventilator. His BP was very low, so hardly he was having any blood pressure to maintain his other organs of the body. We supported his blood pressure, so we continued on the ventilation. We supported him with a dialysis for his kidney recovery and all. So almost he required about 7 to 8 times of the dialysis. The main challenge was he was already having a very poor cardiac function. So his pumping activity was hardly 20-25%. So then with multi-organ involvement, so from my ICU team, so we supported each and other supportive care, including his nutritional care. So he had lots of complications with his infection, he had a pneumonia. So he was on ventilator, so his oxygen was very bad, so we supported him with a very high oxygen support and all. So he failed multiple attempts of coming out of the ventilation with his age, which was not contributing for his recovery. So then slowly we optimized his antibiotic care, so continued on the dialysis. So we were not able to succeed in removing his wind means support which we given through the endotracheal tube. So finally we done something called tracheostomy. We put a hole in his neck and we taken out the big tube from him. So slowly So we removed away from the ventilation. So we started having some urine production. So we gradually decreased the frequency of the dialysis, and we mobilized, continued on the physiotherapy, continued on feeding with the nasal tube. So gradually, over a period of almost 1.5 months, he was in a shape. We saved his life. So slowly we removed this tracheostomy tube also, and we mobilized him out of the ICU. So why I am sharing this story is, bringing any patient who is young with multiple complications from the ICU and giving him some sort of life is not a big deal. So a patient who is elderly with lots of comorbidities, with a compromised immune status, he was a diabetic also. So that adds to lots of complication in terms of lowering the immunity and make him more susceptible for the infection. But with all these challenges, so with a good team effort, so we are able to bring him out of the ICU. So here one point I want to mention, the support of family is very important. His wife, his daughter, son, they supported throughout the journey of near about 1.5 to 2 months of ICU stay. And after that, he has been shifted to ward, in the ward. So he's been slowly given a good rehabilitation care with a multidisciplinary physiotherapy, occupation therapy and all. Slowly, over a period of 10 days, we discharged him home. So, but the story not ended there only. After going to home, he had both the side collection of fluid in his lung. Again, he came back. He was admitted in ICU with a breathing difficulty. I thought this time it's going to end. But he was a fighter. Again, we taken out the fluid from his lung, continued on his medications for his like heart, kidney, asthma, and we given antibiotics for his infection. So this time also he make it in a good way. So slowly again we discharged. So currently down the line after 6 months, so he's entirely independent, is happily leading his life, is able to do exercise, is able to do morning walk also. So he's a retired person, so he's happily living with his family. So this is really a second life for him with the multidisciplinary approach, with a team work from Muzamdar Shah Medical Center, Medical Intensive Care Unit. Thank you all.